We welcome the Democratic nominee for president, Secretary Clinton, and the Republican nominee for president, Mr. Trump. Secretary Clinton, in a speech you gave to a Brazilian bank for which you were paid $225,000, we've learned from the WikiLeaks that you said this, and I want to quote, "My dream is a hemispheric common market with open trade and open borders." Is that your dream, open borders?
Well, if you went on to read the rest of the sentence, I was talking about energy. You know, we trade more energy with our neighbors than we trade with the rest of the world combined. And I do want us to have an electric grid, an energy system that crosses borders. I think that would be a great benefit to us. But you are very clearly quoting from WikiLeaks. And what's really important about WikiLeaks is that the Russian government has engaged in espionage against Americans. They have hacked American websites, American accounts of private people, of institutions. Then they have given that information to WikiLeaks for the purpose of putting it on the internet. This has come from the highest levels of the Russian government, clearly from Putin himself, in an effort, as 17 of our intelligence agencies have confirmed, to influence our election. So I actually think the most important question of this evening, Chris, is finally, will Donald Trump admit and condemn that the Russians are doing this and make it clear that he will not have the help of Putin in this election?
That was a great pivot off the fact that you want open borders, okay? How did we get on to Putin? So just to finish on the borders, she wants open borders, now we can talk about Putin. I don't know Putin. He said nice things about me. If we got along well, that would be good. Look, Putin, from everything I see, has no respect for this person.
Well, that's because he'd rather have a puppet as president of
no
the United
puppet,
States.
No puppet.
And it's pretty clear.
You're the puppet.
It's pretty clear you won't admit
no,
that
the
Russians have engaged in cyber attacks against the United States of America.
There's no idea whether it's Russia, China, or anybody else.
I am not quoting myself.
No idea.
I am quoting
Hillary, you
17.
Have no idea.
17 intelligence. Do you doubt 17
our
military
has
and
no
civilian
idea.
Agencies? Well,
yeah,
he'd rather believe Vladimir Putin than the military and civilian intelligence professionals who are sworn to protect us. I find that just absolutely.
She doesn't
right.
like. Trump, excuse me. Putin has
Mr.
outsmarted
Trump,
her in
Mr.
Syria.
Trump,
he's outsmarted her
here.
Every
I
step
to,
of the way.
I do get to ask some questions. Do you condemn any interference by Russia in the American election?
By Russia or anybody else?
You condemn their interference?
Of course I condemn. Of course I can. I don't know Putin. I have
I'm
no
not
idea.
Asking, I'm asking
I never met
condemn.
Putin. This is not my best friend. But if the United States got along with Russia, wouldn't be so bad.
You have been warning at rallies recently that this election is rigged and that Hillary Clinton is in the process of trying to steal it from you. Do you make the same commitment that you will absolutely accept the result of this election?
I will look at it at the time. I'm not looking at anything now. I'll look at it at the time. She's guilty of a very, very serious crime. She should not be allowed to run. And just in that respect, I say it's rigged. Because she should never, Chris, she should never have been allowed to run for the presidency based on what she did with emails and so many other things.
But are you saying you're not prepared now?
I will tell you at the time. I'll keep you in suspense.
Well,
okay?
Chris, let me respond to that because that's horrifying. You know, every time Donald thinks things are not going in his direction, he claims whatever it is rigged against him. The FBI conducted a year-long investigation into my emails. They concluded there was no case. He said the FBI was rigged. There was even a time when he didn't get an Emmy for his TV program 3 years in a row, and he started tweeting that the Emmys were rigged against
him. Should have gotten it.
This is a mindset. This is how Donald thinks. And it's funny, but it's also really troubling.
The Iraqi offensive to take back Mosul has begun. If they are successful in pushing ISIS out of that city and out of all of Iraq, will you put U.S. troops into that vacuum to make sure that ISIS doesn't come back or isn't replaced?
I will not support putting American soldiers into Iraq as an occupying force.
Iran should write us yet another letter saying thank you very much. Because Iran, as I said many years ago, Iran is taking over Iraq, something they've wanted to do forever, but we've made it so easy for them. So we're now going to take Mosul, and you know who's going to be the beneficiary? Iran.
All these
Iran is taking over Iraq.
Secretary Clinton.
Iran is taking over Iraq. We don't gain
Secretary
anything.
Clinton.
We would have gained if they did it by surprise.
Wait. Neither of you has a serious plan that is going to solve the fact that Medicare is going to run out of money in the 2020s, Social Security is going to run out of money in the 2030s, and at that time, recipients are going to take huge cuts in their benefits.
I'm cutting taxes. We're going to grow the economy. It's going to grow at a record rate.
But that's not going to help on entitlements.
It's going to totally help you. And one thing we have to do, repeal and replace the disaster known as Obamacare.
Well, Chris, I am on record as saying that we need to put more money into the Social Security Trust Fund. That's part of my commitment to raise taxes on the wealthy. My Social Security payroll contribution will go up, as will Donald's, assuming he can't figure out how to get out of it. But what we want to do is to replenish the Social Security Trust Fund by making sure that we have sufficient resources.
Tell the American people why they should elect you to be the next president.
You know, I've been privileged to see the presidency up close, and I know the awesome responsibility of protecting our country and the incredible opportunity of working to try to make life better for all of you. I have made the cause of children and families really my life's work. That's what my mission will be in the presidency. I will stand up for families against powerful interests, against corporations. I will do everything that I can to make sure that you have good jobs with rising incomes, that your kids have good educations from preschool through college. I hope you will give me a chance to serve as your president.
Make America great again. We're going to make America great. We have a depleted military. It has to be helped, has to be fixed. We have the greatest people on earth in our military. We don't take care of our veterans. We take care of illegal immigrants, people that come into the country illegally better than we take care of our vets. That can't happen. Our policemen and women are disrespected. We need law and order, but we need justice too. Our inner cities are a disaster. You get shot walking to the store. They have no education. They have no jobs. I will do more for African Americans and Latinos than she can ever do in 10 lifetimes. And we are going to make America great again, and it has to start now. We cannot take 4 more years of Barack Obama, and that's what you get when you get her.
One thing everyone here can agree on, we hope you will go vote.